and the new district chairman, just taken over from Don recently. I was invited here today just to say a few words, but importantly to welcome you all so we can all say our passing farewells to Jim for the work that he'd done on behalf of the Legion. Joined the Royal British Legion in 2018, and within, I think it was 5 months from joining the Legion, he became your chairman of the Benidorm branch. Quite an achievement. Most people spend years building up to get to chairman, so that goes to show the mark of the man and how we can look back on happy times and remembering Jim. His work for the poppy appeal, obviously in Benidorm with the poppy appeal launch that you host so well every year, Jim was a key part of that, and on behalf of the district, I'd just like to remember Jim for his work of the poppy appeal and the hundreds of thousands of euros raised in Benidorm every year. Format this afternoon, you've had the introduction from me. We're going to have a video, two eulogies, last post, Ravalli, and then in good times we'll remember Jim as such a true gentleman and a member of the Royal British Legion. Thank you.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everybody. Thank you all for coming. Rosie, I'm Benny, I'm Alistair's son. This is just the abridged version of the eulogy that I read out at his funeral. I managed to get it from 10 pages to 2.5 pages. Not that I'm one that likes to talk a lot, those of you that know me. Here we go. James Ian Thomson, Jim Bob, wee Jimmy, my grumpy old man. 2 days after the coronation of Queen Elizabeth II, on the 4th of June 1953, is where the story began. Born in St. Luke's Hospital in Bradford, son to Jock and Vera Thomson, greengrocers of Idle Village, and the younger brother of Margaret. He went to school in Thackley and then on to Eccleshill Grammar. He loved music from an early age and soon picked up the accordion. His dad made him practice for an hour a day, something which turned out to be of benefit, as he started the group, the Three of Clubs, and later on, We Three. Highly successful, they got gigs at lots of the working men's clubs and the social clubs around Yorkshire. The bookings were taken by his dad, Jock, and his mum, Vera, was very proud and often attended. He always played with a pan face. It might have just been concentration, or he didn't like playing, who knows. After school, at the age of 16, Jim became an apprentice gas engineer for British Gas, or NeGas as it was known then. He worked in Shipley, and he would often tell me tales. The most memorable that I remember was when his supervisor nailed the floorboards back down on top of him while he was under the floor, because he wasn't doing the gas pipe work quick enough. He stayed with British Gas for many years. He progressed through becoming the customer service manager at Bradford, Keighley and Ilkley. Jim met Bernadine when he was 23, and they got married at the Holy Trinity Church in Idle on the 5th of August 1978. Jim and Bernadine's first child, my sister Laura, was born on the 20th of September 1980 in the BRI, and they moved house to Cottingley in West Yorkshire. Their second child, me, was born on the 22nd of May 1982. You all know how old I am this year. They moved house to Heaton shortly afterwards. Laura and I remember on Saturdays, Jim would buy fish and chips and they would watch the wrestling while my mum was at work in Halifax at British Gas. Jim enjoyed the family holidays with the children in the early days to Wales and Cornwall in the trailer tent. When the children were older, we went to mainland Spain and Tenerife. On one occasion, Jim was trying to speak Spanish, so he asked Bernadine what the Spanish was for a cigar. She said it was puro. He came back very confused and somewhat angry, as he had not been understood why, and when we asked him what he'd asked for, he said he'd asked for a burro, a donkey, to those of you who don't speak Spanish. We still laughed about this for years after. Jim was a keen course fisherman from an early age, and he had many photos taken with the fish that he had caught. I remember he once told me about a large pike that he had caught in the river, which he brought back and photographed, and then he put it back in the canal, where it terrorised the other fish. We have all heard about a fisherman's tale. He said it was nearly 4 feet long, but the photograph shows otherwise. This love of fishing saw him take part in many competitions, although sometimes the only thing that he caught was a cold. Fishing adventures took him to Dromore near Stranraer in Scotland, where he bought a static caravan with his friend, and they used to go every weekend. He also went on a course so that he could captain a little fishing boat that they called Yorkshire Lass. I bought him the captain's hat in Spanish Capitan, something that we often joked about, thinking he was the captain of a little boat. He was also a member of the Knights of St. Columba, which is a Catholic organisation through which he was invited to go to Lourdes in France with the HCPT Offaly Group. The HCPT is a group that's established for many years. It was originally known as the Handicapped Children Pilgrimage Trust. Obviously, it's now being shortened now, political correctness, to the HCPT. We used to take disabled and disadvantaged children on holiday. He asked me if I would come with him, and our first visit was in 1999. We went every single year after that before we moved here in 2016. He enjoyed the visit, which we went once a week to Cavani in the mountains, as that was somewhere that he felt at peace. It was through the nights in the HCPT that Jim would go to the local social club in Otley, where he attended many barbecues and went on the Black Sheep brewery trips with the others from the club. He enjoyed his beer and woe betide anybody who served beer in the wrong glass, as most of you will remember. He also enjoyed watching rugby union and went all over with friends to support England. Several trips to Twickenham and the Six Nations competition, which is on now, is his favourite. In 1995, Jim and Bernadine bought the old gas showroom in Guiseley. Bernadine worked in the showroom, and Jim went back on the tools, fitting fires, cookers and central heating boilers. In the end, they had expanded the team, having three teams of engineers and six members of staff that worked in the showroom. It was established as one of the top showrooms in the area of Yorkshire. My sister and I also worked in the showroom, which I ended up managing for the last 10 years. And my brother-in-law, Scott, also trained to be a gas engineer, following in his father-in-law's footsteps. They had the shop for over 20 years. When Jim moved to Otley in West Yorkshire in 2005, he made the Summer Cross pub his local. Then after that, it went to the Manor and the Blade, the White Swan. He met a few of the Otley characters, shall we say, and I remember them all sitting around like the knights of the round table at the back of the pub. The banter was quick and curt as they sharpened their wit on each other. He used to go on them self-development workshops, and in one year he went to Skyros, one of the Greek islands. I remember him saying he stormed out of the room as he didn't agree with what was being said. He opened the door and it was pitch black. He'd only walked into the broom cupboard in his haste. He did see the funny side though. He could laugh at himself. He had a sharp wit and self-depreciating humour. In 2015, the business was sold, Classical Gas. Time for a change of direction. I had decided that I wanted to do something else and move to Benidorm. Of course, Jim had to follow. Originally for 2 weeks, then for 6 weeks, he went back to the UK for 10 days, and he stayed for 6 years. The reason I think he came back, he felt welcome in the community of the old town. He enjoyed being in different groups and helping out wherever he could. When he moved to Spain, he became a member of the British Royal British Legion, and he could regularly be seen with his shopping trolley, collecting the poppy appeal boxes. They call him Poppy Jim around the bars in Benidorm. As you've already said, he soon became the chairman of the Benidorm district, a position which he felt very proud of and he held for several years. He was proud to take part in the Remembrance Day parades and lay the wreath at the cenotaph. Jim became a firm member of the Grumpy Old Men's Club, and he made sure that his point was more than known. If he didn't agree with you, he would make his opinion known. I called him Victor Meldrew, and my grumpy old man. Speaking to lots of people about this, they all said this, but many people have told us he was a gentleman, and he would do anything for them. Generous, and sometimes too generous. They have, however, also called him pig-headed, opinionated, and a real pain in the... He would be proud of these titles. He used to get frustrated with the security system at the airport. His titanium hips used to set off the alarm. I called him Swivel Hips. We tried to teach him Spanish for new hips so he could explain to the security. But his Spanish was terrible, and they didn't understand him. Jim was a proud father and grandfather. He would often be at Café Clee, telling everyone how proud he was of me. I think he secretly wished that he had moved out sooner. But to everything there is a season, and that was Jim's time in Spain. Like many people, he found it tough during the lockdown, but he was glad that he was able to speak to his family almost every day. Many texts and FaceTimes with the children and the grandchildren. He went too soon, but we are glad that as family we got to say our farewells to him, even if only by telephone, and know that he will be missed. Thank you.
Even Nigel said, great guy. So long, Jim comes to the first meeting, 4:11. Okay. Please meet you. From that day on, we were the best of friends, within the Legion, without the Legion. And I always remember I was a fond, fond friend. We used to meet up in the old town and get pissed. That's what you do when you go to old time. The last thing but I remember was we were at Armed Forces Day. Did you not come and sit beside me? So on the video you see me standing there and all you see is Jim's elbows. He was a lovely man and that's all I can say, and he'll be fair in this. Okay, thank you.
Let's just say I met Jim when, just probably pre-pandemic, when they came up here to talk about using this place as the home for the British Legion. I used to be a member of the Legion in Benidorm 11 years ago, went in, they came back, blah, blah, refused to join, came and had a chat. Could you be social secretary? Wonderful. He had met Maggie, height difference. Then he met me. Now, bearing in mind, Jim Thomson had no experience of the military at all. He might have been a member of the British Legion, he had never had no history with the military. Met me. Not only time in the army, female, and from Northern Ireland, and from the Shankill Road, and he came in here. The discussions we had about the flags in the room, because obviously Jim was a Catholic, I'm a Protestant from the Shankill. Many a chat over a drink or two. Yes, I called him a grumpy old man, trying to get him speaking to Alistair earlier, trying to get do the membership cards for the puppy appeal, trying to get a photograph of him smiling so it wouldn't look like he was a robber when he went to the Plymouth. It was ridiculous. But hats off to him. I tell you what, that man did something in this town that nobody else has ever did. Nobody. And that's in the 12 years history I have with the British Legion here. We divide up the areas when it comes to the puppy appeal. And you're talking about couples. And on average, we get 15, 16 bars to go around to deliver the puppy appeal stuff, to deliver the boxes, they have to go and collect it. He did 31 on his own in the old town. No car, shop and trolley, which made him even look more like a burglar. With his shop trolley. And as I say, they knew him as the puppy man. When I got his list and was going through his list, I was like, right, no one else would do that. They just physically wouldn't do it, car or not. And especially with the area that he did, because that's the problem that we have this year. He swore to me when I took over as chairperson in November that he would be around to help me. And funny enough, I was doing some paperwork the other day and I just thought, yeah, right, thanks for that, big lad. Let me down. But then when we're looking at the areas, I need to put 3 people in that area next year because they just couldn't do it. Amazing, amazing. Walked it with the weights of the boxes. We've people here that just to carry the box from the bar into their car to bring down here. And he did it in a truck. Absolutely amazing, man. And salute him. He did... loved the social occasion, loved the social occasion. Used to wind me up because as a social secretary, I do out emails, especially during the pandemic. We're having a social function up here at this date. Please can you let me know because we need to do it with numbers because we're socially distanced, blah, 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 blah. Did I ever email? No. Then when I seen him, he was my Mr. Plus One. Because I used to say, even my husband's birthday, I want you all to come 60th birthday, we're having a show, we'll need to know how many's going. You can bring a friend, yeah, plus one. Who are you bringing, Jim, for the place? I don't know yet. Because that was it. I don't know, but I'll bring someone. We had many's a lot with him when he would turn up with random people going like, and you'd never see them again. Like, great personality, out socializing. Loved the masks. Alistair has one of his masks on that we made. He was the biggest salesman around Benidorm with the masks, going in with selling them, coming back down, can I have more? He was selling them quicker than I could make them. Same as the t-shirts with the branch t-shirts. Loved the word, loved everything about the Legion. Loved everything about Benidorm. And everybody says, yes, he was a lovely, when I first met him, I thought he's a big, gentle, quiet gent. No, he's not. We had many a discussion over issues in the Legion, that he was going to go out and get a baseball bat and batter someone in the head. That's what they were told. But unfortunately, he left us very, very suddenly. Very suddenly. As I say, my last conversation with him was in November, and he was planning on coming back and what he was doing. And I think to everybody in the room, it was such a shock. Because we knew that he wasn't well. He hadn't been well from like before the gala dinner. But such a shock that he was taken away from us. And it will leave a massive hole in the British Legion in Benidorm and for everybody that met him. And all I can say is, rest easy up there, big man. I'll drink a drink for you today. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, please be upstanding. They shall grow not old, as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun, and in the morning, we will remember them.
We will remember them.
Thank you.
when you go home, tell them of us and say, for your tomorrow, we gave our today. Thank you.